You know, I've never admitted this before, but I'm scared of being hugged. I'm scared to let myself be held tight in an embrace of compassion, even by those I love. I'm terrified of the idea that they can squeeze the air from my lungs or let go too soon. When my mom tries to hug me, I rarely wrap my arms back around her because I think what I'm really scared of is admitting my feelings. I've never been the first to say I love you or write love poems during the fact. It's always the aftermath of a squashed heart and crushed dreams. That's why I can't have so many people trapped in my heart. It's a castle guarded by the best defense a solitary life can buy, keeping me safe from my own feelings. Yet, when my mom pulled me aside after school onto the couch where we shared stories of happy memories and good times to come, and she told me her cancer had relapsed, perhaps that's when the castle walls crumbled, crashing down like an avalanche, burying me as she held me close, because what I'm really scared of is that people will disappear before I know they love me and they know I love them. I'm really scared that one day my mom will walk into her chemotherapy session and never come out. This malignant gene will spread to her whole body, enveloping the castle in her heart before I have a chance to reach it. I've been scared of hospitals my entire life, but I'll get past this immobilizing fear for her because I love my mom and I know she loves me, but I never know how to say the words, so I keep them internalized in my castle as the fears consume me, and all the nights could never defend my heart when I'm my own enemy. Because if I can't even tell my family how I feel, what makes me think I can ask a therapist for help? As this fire consumes me, I think about how hard it is for my mom to keep caring about how I feel as she loses all she knows. Her hair, her heart, her hope. They say with the chemo, it goes from a 20% chance of the cancer coming back to a 10% chance, as if there isn't a 100% chance of me locking myself away more and more inside that prison I call a castle, because I'm a prince terrified to lose the queen, yet I can't fight. All I can do is let her hold me close, willing my arms to move from my side, yet they stay pinned in place like a toy soldier's, because what I'm really scared of is that if I admit how I feel, it'll all be over too soon and she'll be gone. Just a name in an obituary, beloved by all, but forgotten to time. But I have to try to face my fears, to let her into my heart, because there's a 100% chance I will never forget this feeling, and a 100% chance I wrote this poem to say what I have never been able to say before. In this moment, Mom, let me be the first to say, I love you.